Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Let's start with the third part of species category. We were discussing the limitation of biological species concept. We were discussing evolutionary intermediacy. So here the other one is pathogenetic species formed through hybridization. So hybridization, that result in the production of individual with one chromosome set from parental species A and another from parental species B, leads to doubling of chromosome set, which is known as allotetraploidy. So in animals where cross-fertilization is also always compulsory, a new allotetraploid can maintain itself by switching to parthenogenesis, because in such case allotetraploid cannot like go for fertilization. So what happens, it will switch itself to parthenogenesis. In such case, we cannot apply biological species concept. Then there is semi-species and allospecies. So geographic isolates occasionally have an intermediate status, like those species which are geographically isolated, they have like intermediate status between subspecies and species, which are known as semi-species. So on the basis of some criteria, they would be considered species. On the basis of other criteria, they are not. So these intermediate taxa are known as semi-species, which cannot be like explained through biological species concept. In another case, such geographic isolates have evidently reached the species level. In another example, you will see that these geographic isolates, they are reached to species levels, but still they have some members of super species. So such populations are referred to as allospecies. So again, it is not cannot be explained through biological species concept. Another species concept, that is evolutionary species concept, sorry for the spelling mistake, it's species. So evolutionary species concept, evolutionary species concept was put forward by Grant in 1971. So he supported biological species concept, but only for sexually reproducing forms. So because there were some limitations, evolutionary intermediacy and sexual reproduction and many other things. So the same view point was expressed by Miglitish in 1951 and George Gaillard Simpson in 1961. So this concept of Grant is applicable not only to apomictic population but also to fossil lineages. So the problem of neonatologist and paleontologist was also solved, and that of the asexually reproduction population were also solved through this evolutionary species concept. So Simpson defined evolutionary species concept as a lineage. So it's a lineage of ancestral descendant sequence of population, mean a population which is attached to each other by ancestor and descendant sequence, that it's coming from the same ancestors as a lineage. And this lineage, the animals and the species in this lineage, they are evolving separately from other groups with its own unitary role and tendencies. So they have their own evolutionary role and their tendencies. They are tend toward what things are tend, and how they evolve going through evolution, from the rest of the populations. So it's a lineage of ancestral descendant sequence of population. So this was the definition of evolutionary species concept by Simpson. Willey in 1978 reconsidered this concept, and he stated that species is a single lineage of ancestor and descendant population, a lineage that is descendant from ancestors of organisms which maintain its own evolutionary tendencies and historical fate. So it's also maintain its historical fate because they still have those genes which is expressing in them, which were present in their ancestors, and they have their own evolutionary tendencies. So this was given by Willey. So criticism on this concept was, the drawback of this concept is that it is actually defining phyletic lineages or phylogenetic lineage or ancestor descendant lineage. It's not actually defining a species. It's actually the definition of phyletic lineages or phylogenetic lineage or ancestor lineages. It is not the actual definition of a species, so that was discarded. Then there is mat recognition species concept. So this concept was put forward by Peterson and Lombard et al. In 1907 as a replacement to the biological species concept. So according to this concept, a species is the most inclusive population of individuals biparental organism that share a common fertilization system, or members of each species recognize each other as a potential mate no matter if they are different morphologically or behaviorally. So according to the mate recognition system, mate recognition concept, a species is inclusive population, mean they are inclusive. The individual of biparental organism, they share common fertilization system, mean they recognize each other as potential mate, and then they if they are morphologically different or behaviorally they are different, it doesn't matter, but they recognize each other in a common fertilization system and they reproduce. So this was the definition according to the mate recognition concept. So the organism recognize each other as mates. This recognition may be active through courtship rituals or and responses, or passive as in mechanism of gamete fusion. So this may be passive, where gametes meet. So there is a passive mechanism, and maybe it's active, like in case of courtship rituals. So through courtship rituals or passive fusion of gametes, it occurs and they recognize each other. Criticism. So this concept was not received support, has not received support, because Bulletin in 1987 and Coney et al. In 1988 did not support this concept and found that they actually misinterpret the Mayer's original idea of biological species concept. Another species concept is a phenetic species concept. So according to phenetic species concept, it's actually a pre-Darwinian concept. So in this concept, morphology and physical appearance was criteria, while genetics was ignored. Like according to this concept, if two organisms are resembling with one another morphologically, if they have morphological resemblance, so irrespective of genetic cohesiveness or similarity, then they are regarded as species. So in this concept, all the criteria for a species was given to the morphology. If two organisms are morphologically similar, they were considered a species. It doesn't matter if they are genetically different, they are similar or different from each other, but the phena, or actually the morphology, was given all the credit. Then there is a phylogenetic species concept. So according to this concept is actually a reformulation of evolutionary species concept. Again, you can say it's a phylogenetic, related to the phylogeny of the organism. So this concept was put forward by Sampson and other co-worker, that is why it is also known as Sampson. According to this concept, species is an irreducible, it's a basic grouping of organism diagnosably distinct from other groupings, and within which there is a parental pattern of ancestry and descendant. So according to Sampson, species is irreducible, it's a basic grouping organism, or they are different from other such groupings, and they have parental pattern of ancestry and descendant. They are descended from common ancestors. Then there is isolated species concept. So according to this concept, species are systems of population. The gene exchange between these systems is limited or prevented by a reproductive isolated mechanism. So according to them, species are systems of populations, and the gene exchange between these systems is limited or prevented. How it is prevented? Well, the same species will reproduce with the same species, and this this flow of gene, exchange of gene, is restricted to the similar species. They cannot exchange their genes to another group of organisms. So those which can exchange their genes with each other are actually species. So species have different population. Within species, gene can exchange, but between system, gene cannot exchange. I mean, like for example, there are population of donkeys and horse and dogs and goats and sheep. So they cannot exchange gene within the system, but sheep can exchange the gene with sheep, and goat can exchange gene with sheep, and donkey can exchange genes with donkey, and horse can exchange genes with horse. So they are like reportedly isolated through isolated mechanism. Then there is a cohesion species concept. So according to cohesion species concept was actually given by Templeton in 1989, and he attempted to collect ideas of all species concept and converted it into a new or one way definition called cohesion species concept. He collected all the definition in one. Like, he used the idea of biological species concept, mate recognition species concept, evolutionary species concept, ecological species concept, and genealogical species concept, and he grouped these all into one. And according to it, a combination of ecological and reproductive cohesion is important for maintaining a species evolutionary unity and integrity. So a combination of ecological and reproductive cohesion mean species will be occupying the same ecology, and they will have reproductive cohesion, and most important is the species will maintain its evolutionary unity and integrity. So he collected all the things in this definition, all the species concepts. Or he defined the species as: species is the most inclusive population of individuals having a phenotypic cohesion, mean they are similar due to intrinsic cohesion, they have reproductive cohesion, and they have they determined by gene flow within themselves. So this was the definition of cohesion species concept. Then there is ecological species concept. So ecological species concept by put forward by one villain in 1976, and according to this concept, a species is a lineage, it's a lineage descended from the same parent, that occupies an adaptive zone. This species will occupy that zone to which they are best adapted, minimally different from that of any other lineage, and their zone will be minimally, at least at very minute level, it will be different from the other lineage which is living in its range and which is evolving separately from other lineages outside its range. And this species will be evolving separately from all other lineages which is living in its surrounding and its range. So this was the ecological species concept. It's a species will having a lineage, and it will occupy adaptive zone, and that adaptive zone will be many different from other lineages in its range, and this species will be evolving separately from all other lineages outside its range. So the lineages which are within its range or which are with outside its range will evolve separately from these. Then there is a biochemical species concept. So biochemical species concept was given by Florkin in 1964. According to this concept, so groups of individuals with more or less similar combination of sequences of purines and pyrimidines, bases in their macromolecules of DNA, and within a system of operators and repressor leading to biosynthesis of similar amino acid sequences. So it's a group of individuals. Those groups of individuals which have more or less similar combination of their DNA, mean their DNA macromolecule have basic units which are known as purines and pyrimidines, and then at pyrimidines and purines it makes the DNA, and we know that in DNA there are operators and repressors. There are genes which operates, and there are some which repress repress the operating of biosynthesis of molecules and then repression of the biomolecule or the amino acid sequences. So these leads to biosynthesis of similar amino acid sequences, and which will ultimately lead into a similar morphology, similar genetic makeup, and the reproductive genes and everything. So if they have similar combination of sequences of purines and pyrimidines based in the DNA system, so such individual will be known as species, single species. So this was biochemical species concept. These are the references, and thank you so much. If you have any question, please feel free to ask question. Thank you.